In today's quickfire questions, we're going to be looking at some pretty difficult mole calculations. So, as with all my quickfire questions, read the question yourself, pause the video, have a go at it, and see if your answer matches mine. So, question one. If hydrogen is passed over copper oxide, it is reduced to metallic copper. Mass of the empty tube was 52.2 grams. Mass of the tube plus copper oxide before the experiment is 66.6 grams. Mass of tube and copper after experiment is 65.0 grams. Find the mass of the oxygen and copper and calculate the empirical formula. So the hardest bit is just working out what these numbers actually mean. So the mass of the tube and the copper was 65 grams. So if I take away 52.2 from that number, which is effectively the mass of the tube, then that will tell me the mass of the copper, which I therefore know is 12.8 grams. And then in the line above, the mass of the tube and copper oxide before the experiment is 6.6 grams. So if I take away 65 grams from that value, then I'll know the mass of oxygen. So that's 1.6 grams. So we're ready to get started now. So as always, use the table format. So the mass of copper I've just worked out to be 12.8. The mass of oxygen was 1.6. Use your periodic table to find the MR of copper, which is 63.5. The MR of oxygen is 16. To work out number of moles, you need this formula triangle. So you can see that number of moles is mass divided by MR. So do that for copper first of all. So 12.8 divided by 63.5 to get 0.20157. 1.6 divided by 16 is 0.1. And then because it's an empirical formula calculation, to find out the ratio, you want to divide both by the smallest number. So identify the smallest number first of all. It's obviously 0.1. So do that divided by 0.1. The same on the other side to get a value which is 2 to 1. So the empirical formula is therefore Cu2O. Question 2. 9.66 grams of copper nitrate combined with water are heated strongly. 7.5 grams remain after heating. Calculate X. This is a water crystallization equation, so you have to do this. It's a similar thing to the empirical formulae calculations, but you just need to separate it like this. So let's divide it up like we did before. So mass, MR, number of moles. So we know that 7.5 grams of the copper nitrate remain after heating, so that value goes in here. To work out the mass of water, we simply take 7.5 away from 9.66 to get 2.16. Let's work out the MR of copper, so use your periodic table. Copper is 63.5. Nitrogen is 14 times 2 because of that 2 behind the bracket. Oxygen is 16 and we need to multiply that by 6. To get 187.5. Water, so the MR of water, so 2 lots of hydrogen is therefore 2 plus 16 for oxygen, so that's 18. To work out the number of moles, we do mass divided by MR, so 7.5 divided by 187.5 gives me 0.04. 2.16 divided by 18 gives me 0.12. To work out the ratio, we divide by the smallest number. So the smallest number in this case is 0.04. And you get a value which is 1 to 3. So therefore X equals 3. Question 3. 35.75 grams of sodium carbonate combined with water are heated strongly. 13.25 grams remain after heating. Calculate X. So, very similar to the question above, separate your formulae out. We've got mass, MR, number of moles. So, we know that 13.25 grams of the sodium carbonate remains. So, let's do 35.75 minus 13.25 to get 22.5 grams of water. Work out the MR of sodium, so you need to do 23 times 2. plus 12 plus 3 lots of 16 to get 106. The MR of water remains the same as above, so 18. To calculate the number of moles of sodium carbonate, do 13.25 divided by 106 to get 0.125. The number of moles of water is 22.5 divided by 18 equals 1.25. Last step, divide by smallest number, which is 0.125. Get a ratio which is 1 to 10. So x equals 10.